And now to discuss the coherent or synchronous QPSK demodulator, we look at figure 922 that shows the functional block diagram of the coherent demodulator of the QPSK. And the figure is right here. This is our figure 922 that describes the functioning of a demodulator for QPSK. What you observe from this figure is that we are receiving the QPSK signal, the one that is causing or realizing phase change by either positive or negative 90 degrees or at some point 180 degrees phase change. And once we have received that kind of a signal that is changing in phase, we want to recover our binary data stream that we had been sent earlier. So I'm not saying that is the one we had sent, but I'm just illustrating that this example is what we expect at the output. Well, this is what we expect at the input. So the first step that we observe is that the QPSK signal is taken through a carrier recovery circuit. What this does is to give us the coherent carrier signals that were modulated at the generation of the QPSK signals. And how we do that is take it through raise the power of the input signal by power of 4, pass it through a bandpass filter that is centered at 4 times the carrier frequency, and then divide by 4. So what that does is to give us the cos omega c of t. We don't have to go through to the details of how that is done. We're just saying that the carrier recovery circuit gives us the carrier signal that is both frequency and phase coherent, or they are in phase, both in frequency and phase. And therefore, that carrier is now taken to each of the balance modulators or product modulators to multiply with the copy of the signal. And we can see how that is done. So what you're saying is that at this stage, we are receiving ST, and ST, another copy of that is received. But if you remember, ST is equals to S1T plus S2 of T. And S1, we have two values, one that is in phase, the other one that is out of phase. Just to correct myself, S1, S of T is comprised of two signals, one that is in phase, the other one that is quadrature. And we have said that the in phase component is multiplied with the odd numbered bit sequence. So we are saying that we are going to have cos omega c of t. This is the in phase component. And then plus the even numbered bits that are multiplied with the sine of omega c of t. So that is what we are receiving at this stage. Therefore, when we multiply it with the cosine, if we multiply this with the cosine of omega c of t, we are going to lose this, and we are going to end up with the result that looks like this. Just remember that B0T cos omega C T plus BE multiplied with cos omega C T. What we end up with is BOT squared sine omega C T cos omega C T. And just as we know, we are taking this signal through the low pass filter that is formed by the integrator. And we can conclusively say that this one will be cut off, and this one will have a DC component and high frequency component. Remember that we normally say that this breaks down into B0 of T divided by 2, 1 plus cos omega 2 or 2 omega C of T. So again, this will be cut off, and we are going to be left with this component. So at this stage, we can conclusively say that we are getting a component or a sequence of non-return to zero pulses that are equivalent to the one that we had sent, that are of even odd bits. And the same side, using the same concept, here we are multiplying with the sine, and the sine is multiplied with the quadrature component. Again, the sine will produce the same effect, and you're going to have the BE at the output of the second correlator. So these two signals are multiplexed to have a sequence of the are of pulses that are in a NPRZ encoded, and those NPRZ encoded signals are taken through the decision making device to either determine whether the pulse is a positive or negative. It is a positive, goes to one. If it is negative, it's considered to be a zero. And that gives us our original transmitted pulses. So having said that, probably we can just lead through and just see if there's anything that we might have missed. And we see now that the power splitter that we have just seen at that at this input directs the input received QPSK signal to the two collectors, the in-phase and the quadrature components. And one of them goes to the carrier recovery circuit. We have seen that this carrier recovery circuit produces for us the original transmitted carrier signal, which is in phase, both in frequency and in phase. And we also say that the coherent carrier signals recovered are applied to the two collectors to produce the one high frequency component and a DC component. The high frequency component is removed by the integrator, and we are able to generate either the even and the odd pulses for each of the correlators. So those two outputs are multiplied to the bit combining circuit, the one we are calling the multiplexer or MUX, and that now generates for us a synchronized, or rather a serial output of bits that we anticipate that should have been sent. Of course, the impulses form that are then taken to the detection device or device making device to give for us the binary output data.